Charlie called Henry the tulip bulb, Hendrix, I believe it was, wasn't it? Well, he's been called a turnip, he's been called an onion, all kinds of things. This is my book, Henry's Life as a Tulip Bulb. It's the first in 8 in the series. I originally wrote this book in 1983 for TV production and a little TV station in Lima, Ohio. And I understand that Ernie knows probably where Lima is. But this little production was just that. It was for a production called Sunshine Muppets. And it's a story about a little tulip bulb who feels very safe and satisfied in his cellophane bag in a Harper's store grocery shelf. And suddenly his life changes when two little girls come in and buy him. They rip him out of his bag, they throw him in the ground, they stomp manure on his head, and that's when Henry goes, "My life stinks!" And he goes through all of the stages that a tulip bulb goes through, and along the way, a voice is speaking to him. And Henry is sometimes receptive, sometimes angry, sometimes depressed, sometimes belligerent. But at the end, when he becomes the tulip, he realizes had he stayed safe and satisfied on the grocery store shelf, he would have never become who he was meant to have become. And that's when he recognizes an attitude of gratitude is where it all exists. And so the subtitle of this book is Developing an Attitude of Gratitude. You never heard that in 1983. I was a Christian then, but I was pretty much living my own life. I had homes on both coasts, was a drummer in a band. I had 3 beautiful children. I was an artist, I was a writer, I traveled a lot. And then 8 years ago, I came tumbling to my knees when my son, Scotty, was killed. And then 2 years later, I was diagnosed with an extremely rare brain tumor. And after 10 and a half hour surgery and 25% of my brain, I am the only recorded adult survivor in the world. It took me 13 months of crawling through my house, learning to walk again, learning to paint again, learning to drive again. And 3 years ago, I was on a walker. I went to a Christmas party in St. Augustine, Florida, and 4 people who had originally ordered what they thought was a book from the TV station were at that party. You talk about God's miraculous plan for your life. I said, I don't know, there could be a book soon. And they said, well, if you ever publish it in a book, we want it. And then I came home from the party, and that same night, there was a voicemail from a publisher who said, yeah, you know that little book you showed me a couple years ago? I want it, so call me. So I called him. Henry has become an animated picture for DreamWorks. As I said, it's the first of 8 books, and I told my mother what I was doing with Henry, and we're traveling around the country speaking for hospice. I just got home night before last in from West Palm Beach, where I'm speaking with them. And so my mother said, oh, Linda, you have the next Henry Potter. And I said, oh, Mom, I don't think that's a Freudian slip. And she said, who? And I went, never mind, Mom. It's all right. So, you know, the thing I could tell you is that if you have a little idea and you give it to God, which I ended up giving my life and everything to God, that God can take a little tulip bulb and touch people's lives, and he can take your idea and touch their lives as well. So I'm back in the back. I've got Henry books, and he's got his own website, henrythetulipbulb.com. You'll have to go on it. It's some really cool things with visiting the children in the schools. Oh, I gotta tell you one little story. I'm very careful when I go into the public schools that I call it the voice in the book. And one little girl had been with me for about 3 days, and she came running up beside me, and she said, Miss Linda, Miss Linda, who's the voice? And I said, well, who do you think it is? Her name's Lorraine. And who do you think it is? And she said, well, it's either Mother Nature or God. And I whispered in her ear, and I said, it's God. And she went, yes! So that does encourage me that children do want to know that there is a God and there's a God that cares and loves for them very much. So if you get a chance, stop back and see me. I'm here for the afternoon.